Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Yesterday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 26 mission with another payload on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One, engines full power, and lift off of Starlink 2-6. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There we can see the landing burn has begun for the first stage, targeting a landing on our drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
There you can see Falcon 9 has successfully landed on our drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You. Marking the 168th overall landing of an orbital class rocket, including F9 and Falcon Heavy missions.
Nominal parking orbit.
We can hopefully expect another Starlink mission to lift off this week. The Starlink 5-3 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 2nd at 7:43 a.m. UTC or 2:43 a.m. EST. SpaceX posted a tweet saying Starlink is now available in Nigeria, the first African country to receive service. Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley were the first people to fly on Crew Dragon, and I wanted to share this tweet from NASA. It says, on Tuesday, January 31st, Demo 2 astronauts Douglas Hurley and Robert Behnken will receive the Congressional Space Medal of Honor for bravery. Heading to Boca Chica, here's Booster 7 sitting on the orbital launch mount. Work continues on the new foundations at Starbase. There was a tweet posted related to the Starship Tower being constructed at Pad 39A in Florida. It says, SpaceX moved the chopsticks and carriage to 39A. They were moved onto a temporary work platform where they were connected and then lifted onto the tower. The chopsticks will be used to stack and catch Starship and Super Heavy. This booster aft section was seen being moved into a fabrication tent. Somebody posted a screenshot of the SpaceX website, unaware that SpaceX planned to fly Starship in expendable mode. Everyday Astronaut posted, I would love to know more about what exactly is being expended in expendable mode. Are we talking an expended upper stage? Does HLS count? Expended Super Heavy? Both? I'd imagine if it's both, it'd be a lot more than 250 tons even. Musk responded with, expendable upper stage may or may not fly, but it is an option. There was a tweet posted related to Musk flying to Starbase. It says, as of Sunday afternoon, January 29th, 2023, rumor has it that the map below indicates Elon Musk, or at least his private jet, has returned to Brownsville, Texas on his way back to Starbase so that he can be on site for the much-anticipated Booster 7 33 engine static fire test. So this could mean that we'll see a 33 engine static fire pretty soon. The crane lifting points have been removed from Starship 24. The Starship 28 nose cone was seen moved to the high bay. Two Raptor engines were swapped out on Booster 7 recently. I wanted to share this super cool picture that Elon Musk posted on Twitter of Super Heavy Booster 7. He said, just leaving the engine bay of Starship. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures, the dates for yesterday and today were cancelled. However, SpaceX currently have a possible closure for Friday 3rd as well as Monday 6th and Tuesday 7th. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.